Hi there. Today's topic will be chapter number 7, God Has a Life Work for You. Okay, and it's the same book. We're at chapter 7, and this is the book of my mom. It's been an old, it's called the Handbook of Life, and it's indicated that with God, all things are possible. Okay, so it's stated here that, you know, a lot of human beings are more so uncontent with, you know, what they do or where they are in that position, because that's the nature of human. We always think that it's always greener on the other, you know, our neighbor or whatever. We're always looking at what we don't have, so to speak, right? And there are times that, you know, we wanted to be perhaps like everybody else wants to be, a lawyer maybe, or a doctor or a surgeon, and everybody wants to be that as a kid, you know, then who's going to be the farmer, right? That type of concept. But you know, there are times that God made you to be a farmer, but then you ended up becoming a lawyer just because, you know, you were born at the family of a lawyer, and that's how the family tradition, you know, and you ended up being that. But because of the money and the status and all that, you ended up liking it, and you ended up working with it and trying to adopt it. It causes unhappiness, but you could also have the other one as a hobby, if you may, right? To please your own. You know, you think you will excel in that, right? Well, why not try to use it as a hobby, because God wants you to be successful. Okay, so I'm going to be reading you know, some passages here that will really give you some hint, or give you some valuable guide, signs, or perhaps whoever's listening this today or in the future, I will know that God is talking to them. Okay, so believe in God's love and you will believe in yourself. Believe in yourself and you will believe in your work. Believe in your work and you will be happy and prosperous. Prosperous in the truest sense of the word. Okay? And keep this in mind, there's no task on this earth that is unimportant. I know people are very judgmental, especially if it's, you know, it's not those high-end job or it requires, you know, you have to be adaptable to that. And it requires humility, right? And that's actually, if it's a dignified job, as long as you are not stealing, you're not doing anything wrong to any humankind, then you should be proud of it. Okay? So yes, if you have talents of believing God in yourself, and as surely as day follows night, God will bring them forth. If you really are fitted for bigger, better things, and you base your belief in God's plan, then as certain as sunlight, God will guide you. For he never puts a craving into a human heart and fails to satisfy it. See? But it's always well to remember that all ambitions, all cravings are not true. They do not come from God. They are built up out of false pictures of success and truth and what is desirable. So God himself has told you how and what to think in order to know whether your ambitions and your cravings are true. He tells you in the most noble words of his Bible, and here they are. Whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things. Check your ambitions and your cravings against these words. Are they true, honest, just, or good report? then think on them. Always think on them. Put that fire on them and let God kind of cook it or make it happen. And when you have thought, there are five things to do next, and the first is the most important. First, ask God to guide you to your life work. You have asked God in the past to look for love, for help, for guidance in dark ways. Why not ask His help in finding the best work for you, the best plan? Tell Him exactly what you think you would like and then wait for His guidance. It will come in ways you may never understand. If you're already in your right work, God will open up new channels for you. If it's not succeeding as it should, He will shine His candle still further into your darkness. And if you are in the wrong work, then deep, sincere prayer, time after time, will open up a new door for you. When you have prayed, believe that you have received it. Believe with all your heart that God will do you as you ask. Believe it just as much as you believe any promise which God has made. God will look out for something for you, only in a bigger and grander way. Now thank you, Father, in spirit and in truth. Thank Him for the word, for the work you already have. For many and many persons who look lightly on their present task, when they lost it, found out what a necessary and comforting and actually happy things it was. And thank you, Father, for what He is going to give you. Have you never said thank you to a friend who promised to do something for you as soon as he get a chance? Well, God has promised you, and He will keep His promise, and now you are ready for the last step. Go out into the world rejoicing in that promise. Act as if you expected it to come to you quickly, around the next corner. So expect it to happen. Okay? Put that in your heart. Rejoice and get ready for it. Expect it, and when you get it, resolve you will always use it. Not as just a means for reward, but as a means for joy. One day, a stranger was crossing a wide river in the south on an old dilapidated ferry boat. He noticed the engineer, a white-haired old man, sitting in the doorway of the engine room and reading a Bible. The old man was dressed in worn old clothes, spotlessly clean, and in his eyes were the wonderful signs of great peace and contentment and happiness. As the stranger talked with the old man, he noticed that although the rest of the boat was dirty and grimy, the engine room was spotlessly clean. He noticed that there was no greasy odor from the engine room, no bilge water under the engine, and the engine was so clean and polished that it shone like a jewel. Said the stranger, "Tell me, sir, how do you keep the engine room so clean, and what is the use when the rest of the boat is so dirty? How are you so happy in your work? It's going back and forth on this deserted river and keeping your engine room clean without anybody noticing it." The old man looked lovingly at his gleaming engine and then at the Bible he was holding in his hand. "It's easy," caption. "It's like this. I got a glory. Just keeping the engine room clean, just making the engine shine and glisten. The cleanest and best engine room on the river was the old man God given work in life, his glory, and with that glory he had everything he needed in life to make him happy. Will you dare to say he was not successful? For success in your work, you will find out sooner or later, is much more than just making money. Yes, it may mean making money, but not when you must lose friends to make it." Keep that in mind. Like, we have a better means to, you know, there's always a purpose to it. Success in your work is just doing the best that you can. It is finding what is finest about it and making hard work an adventure and an accomplishment. It means fighting hard and losing your sense of humor. Yes, it means taking what life has to offer, whether you win or lose, with a smile, for you still can partake of the joy and happiness of your Father, because you have taken time from your work to look up at the stars. Okay. So yes, so if you want to be truly happy, I have to find the work that makes you happy, and then you must look for happiness in whatever work God gives you to do, and you must polish the brass whose shining gives you a glory. just like that story, okay? Will you not pray now for that glory in our prayer that God will lead me to my life work? Okay, so pray that we are given that life work that God has given to us, so that we can have that happiness, true happiness, because it's really hard. So the key as well is putting fire and asking God for guidance, asking God for help for that desire of yours to happen, and keeping that fire also in your heart and working on it and putting an intention and making a promise to God that you will not just make good of that, be of that work or that career that you wanted, or that specific, let's say, a family or whatever you wish, right? And your desire, whatever your heart's desire, you put that intention and leave it there, and He will eventually give it to you in a manner that you will never know. It's like a magic. Okay? So this is derived from the Bible. The Bible is a very, very powerful book. I can't wait to start reading that with you guys and start learning it together. And hope that I could be of help, and I hope that you could also help me. Thank you, and God bless.